Jerry, to get a nip on that over there? Take a little nip.
You take a little. You take a little tasty.
Or was that? Did you get the nose? Were you nosing?
I got a little sip. I got a sample.
Are you a beer drinker, Pete?
Not a big beer drinker, but when we go on the road on Friday nights during Navy football season, we're all out a big group.
Mm-hmm.
I'll partake in a couple of beverages.
Okay.
Because it's unavoidable. People buy them for you. You got to drink it. It's just as a courtesy.
What's your chosen beverage?
Red's Apple Ale, probably, or Angry Orchard.
Yeah, I'm a cider guy, too. Woodchucks were my thing growing up. Enjoyed a woodchuck. Not much in the way of a beer drinker, light beer drinker. I'll have a Coors, I'll have a Miller, what have you. Same thing. If somebody hands me a beer, I'll drink a beer.
Always.
Joe Stamboni, you're more the 50-milligram edible type. But you enjoy a beverage is handed to you?
Yeah. I'm a little snobby. I like my hazy IPAs and
Zombie Dust is his favorite.
Yeah, it's delicious.
Three Scott's the beer drinker. He's the one that sort of helped take
and
point
my body
on this
shows
thing.
That. Okay, I know. Stop texting in about my weight. I know.
He helped us work alongside Union to say we want a beer that people want to buy, but they also want to drink and drink more of, not just put on the collectible shelf to bring it to a backyard crab feast, a Memorial Day barbecue, Labor Day barbecue, whatever. And Val, you have yet to have any.
Can I ask a question first?
Please.
It just popped in my head.
Please.
What made you guys go for the can instead of the glass bottle?
I think it's a cost slash availability
thing. They don't do bottles.
Oh,
yeah, just cans.
Interesting.
Only the big, gigantic breweries do bottles.
Oh,
yeah, if you got a bottle, that's impressive. Plus, cans are easily recyclable.
It's just easier, yeah.
I think
and
it's
you can
easier
have a
to
better bleep. Picture on it.
The way of the bottle
is
gone.
Phasing out?
Yeah, I mean, you can't bring
it's more of a beach
bottles.
Thing, I guess.
Yeah, you got to bring cans everywhere. Right. They only allow cans.
You can't
it's
break a
easier.
Can over someone's head in a beer in a barroom fight. Plus, you have now, like, what are they called? Liquid death?
Yes.
Water?
Yes.
Yeah. Liquid
right,
death. It's for people that have repressed sexuality. Okay, I get it. Every podcaster out there with the Liquid Death sponsorship. Yeah, you don't drink beer. You famously drink what we call the Preactor, which is white wine mixed with a little bit of sweet and low.
Correct.
When's the last time you drank a beer?
That's a great question. Honestly, probably like senior week, maybe in high school.
Mm-hmm.
Wow,
badass!
Yeah,
hell yeah!
The last
I had
time
like
you
a
had
Corona
a beer,
Light, maybe.
You had a Corona Light. Last time you had a beer was a Corona Light senior week of high school.
Definitely more than like 6 years ago.
Wow.
Yeah, I'm not. Okay. I really stay away from beer.
What is that little?
This is stevia. I have just a mixture. I have sweet and low, and if you want, this is liquid stevia.
Wait, so you're
stevia.
Planning on?
Well, it was in there. I only have three of these. So I just brought reinforcements.
What's with the sweet and low in your
so
adult beverages?
I like everything super, super sweet.
Ugh,
and
same.
So my favorite wine is a Moscato. And if they don't have a Moscato and I have to get like a Pinot Grigio, sometimes it's a little too bitter. And so I always carry sweet and low with me and I'll just put a little sweet and low in there.
It's interesting.
Makes it more palatable. I've done it also with like champagne sometimes.
Does anybody ever look at
you? And that explodes.
Does anybody ever look at you like they think you're already drunk because you're putting that in
your
beverage?
She's so wrecked, she thinks it's a coffee. Don't tell. Now, to Pete's beverage of choice, have you had a cider before?
Yeah.
Because I think you might like
Angry Orchard.
You might like a cider. That you can get on the sweet side.
But like, I'd rather not have any type of beer. Like, I'd rather have a straight liquor.
Okay. Well, you got it in front of you.
Now,
go to 99line.com/beer.
And just say what you think and feel and taste.
Okay.
Don't be like, oh, it's good.
You know I'm going to be honest.
Please. There she goes.
Okay.
That's really not bad. It's. At first, I was getting like apple juice notes.
Oh, she's giving us the notes. Go ahead.
Val.
Oh, my God. Jesus.
Turn the mic off.
Wait, second sip,
yeah,
not so much.
It's palatable, but I wouldn't drink it.
Oh, she's making a bad face.
It's also high ABV. It's 6.1.
The back end of a beer to me, it just has such a weird taste on the back end, like in the back of your tongue.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. It's just gross. It's just like not, it's not enjoyable to me.
You're just not a beer drinker.
No.
My old man, not
it's
a beer drinker.
It's
got to
be the hops or something. I don't know.
He's a 7-7 guy. That's it. If on the rare occasion he'll drink a Heineken and he'll hold on to one Heineken
first sip,
for 3 hours.
Not bad though.
It's good. It's an IPL. I learned that phrase. It's a lager,
mm-hmm.
and it's summertime. It's
really
light.
The color's
good.
Fruity. It does.
Yeah, it's got. It's supposed to be like a lager, which is just your average summer beer. Mm-hmm. You're drinking a natural light or a Coors light or a Bud Light.
Should I add the sweet and low and see if it's better?
Go for it.
Yeah, put sweet and low.
It's your beer.
From there, we zhuzhed it up a little. It's a zhuzhed up lager.
I put the whole thing in.
Okay. Well, hello there. Save that. what do you got there in front of you there?
See, it fizzes a little bit.
Is this just a Stambone? Did you just hand me a standard beer?
Yeah, that's just a little leftover.
Appreciate that. Thank you.
Is that that's our beer?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Pete, go ahead and take another little bit. Just a little
bit. Pete Medhurst thing?
Just get it on the palate. Mm. There you go. That was a good one.
Let's swim around the taste buds.
Fantastic.
Thank you, Pete. Appreciate
that. I think it's great. And sometimes I think beer sometimes
way
can be a little bit bitter,
better.
But it's not.
Val's is way better.
I have to try Val's. It's a beer. It's
what
a beer.
Did you put?
Beer drinkers
I put the
and
whole
non-beer
packet
drinkers
of Sweet and Low in there.
Just one Sweet and Low
packet.
So
it could probably use more, but it's
holy
good.
Oh, this. And that's a little bit of beer.
Yeah, it's very sweet.
That's a
very
lot of Sweet and Low for not a lot of liquid.
Oh, my God. And you think it's great now?
It's definitely better.
Okay, this is science, folks.
Do some science. This is science. We've ruined the beer.
It's a lot of foam.
Ooh.
Here we go.
Ooh.
Let's try this. Okay.
Ooh.
We're doing a well hello
Val. That makes it weird. Oh.
I was going to say we won't have.
Ooh. It's a creamy.
Well.
All right. Going well, in. Here we go.
Well hello light.
Ooh. That's off-putting. And I like sweet liquor.
Your tongue is like not knowing what to do with itself.
No,
your tongue's going
go
like,
it,
hey,
Joe.
Wait a
that's
minute.
That's a schizophrenic liquid.
Yes, oh, it's schizophrenic.
Oh,
it's a half.
That is awful.
That's, I'm happy and sad. Yeah. No, we recommend not putting sweet and low in well hello beer. It's good right out of the can. Val, thank you. We'll talk to you again at 7:35.